Hey everybody, John at Freshwater Systems, and in our series of answering frequently asked questions, today we're talking about sump pumps. What do sump pumps do? Sump pumps are submersible pumps that their design and purpose is to move water that accumulates, whether it be runoff from a basement moisture, accumulated water in someone's basement, or in a drain situation where you don't have a line that moves the water to the drain system, you can accumulate it in a tank and the sump pump will push the water to the outside or to some other area when the water accumulates to a certain depth. Do I need a sump pump at my house? Are they necessary? Sump pumps are necessary in a household, especially if you accumulate water in your basement. For example, an older home with a basement is built below ground, and sometimes those basements can be above or below the water table. And that means that water can seep through the foundation of the house, and if you don't have a way to move that water outside, it's going to accumulate and eventually flood your basement. That's where the sump pump comes in. It sits in a pit like our diagram here, and as the water comes through the walls or through the foundation in the basement and accumulates, it runs to this pit. And the sump pump sits in there, and when the water gets to a certain level and the float mechanism raises up, it turns the pump on, evacuates the water from the pit so that it can continuously move that water and moisture outside. How do sump pumps work? Sump pumps are submersible pumps, and they work by a float mechanism that tells the pump when to turn on and when to turn off. So we want this pump to move water outside. A lot of times we'll run the effluent or the discharge line outside to a pit or a ditch, or sometimes even into a French drain kind of a situation. But ultimately they sit in this little pit or they sit submerged in water, and as the float mechanisms raise as the water increases its level in the tank, it gets to a point where it turns the pump on. This one, for example, uses a float switch type mechanism to activate the pump. And it waits till it gets way up here to turn the pump on. And then as it drops in level, it turns the pump off when it gets down about here. This would be used for a higher volume of water move. You want to wait till you get a lot more water before it kicks the pump on. This one would be used in a tank where you have less water height anyway to activate the switch. Where does sump pump water go? Sump pump water discharge goes where you kind of need it to go. For an example, if you're using it in a basement, you're going to run the line up and outside and either run it to a dry well, or run it to a little creek or a pond that you might have. You might run it into a French drain type of a setup. You got to be careful that you don't put it into a French drain that's going to drain right back into the foundation of the house. But basically, you decide where you need the water to go from the discharge of the sump pump. Why do sump pumps fail? Sump pumps fail just like any working mechanism. If they're not used properly, if they're not applied properly, the pump's turning on and off way too many times, too frequently. Cycling is probably the leading cause to any pump failing. Other than that, it's just maintenance. If you put this in a tank of water that's accumulating lots of junk and debris, it's going to be hard on the pump. So just maintaining the pumps properly, and make sure you apply them properly so they don't have an opportunity to prematurely fail. How long will a sump pump last? Sump pumps should last somewhere between 6 and 10 years. If they're applied properly, if they're well maintained, they should last that full lifespan. Well, that's all we have for this topic. I hope you liked it. I hope you got something out of it. If you did, be sure and like this video and subscribe to our channel. And be sure and check us out on our website, freshwatersystems.com.